Welcome to today's video where I'm going to show you how to reverse the typical order of your ListView.builder. For this example, let's just imagine that for some reason you're tracking where you went on each day. And for example, on the 4th you went to McDonald's and you went to Disneyland on the 5th and then KFC, Pizza Hut, AMC, whatever. And then, you know, now it's the 12th of June and you went to, I don't know, the Statue of Liberty. And the day you went there was on the 12th, right? And when I add this to the list, it's going to on top of it. And that's what makes the most sense in this case, because it's July 4th, 5th, you know, the 8th, and then 12th. You know, it makes sense on a date basis. However, this is the finished version. If I restart the app because I changed the code back and I do this again, the first thing you're going to notice is that the dates now begin from the top. So if I come over here and I do the exact same thing, I put in 12. And I'm going to add to the list. And now the order kind of doesn't make as much sense because in this particular example, we want it to show on top. For example, if you have an expenses app, you obviously want the most recent expenses to also show up on top. And in this case, we obviously want to see where we were more recently. We don't want to have to go all the way down to the list just to see the most recent entry. That doesn't make any sense. So I'm just going to go ahead and show you exactly how to reverse the list. All you need to do is come over here to the ListView.builder. And the rest of the code isn't too important at all. This is just an example that I concocted here. But you come over here to your list view builder. And what we're doing right here is we're using the index. And that's essentially what is setting up the order. You're saying, you know, iterate this amount of times. And then you're using the index, right? The index is going to be the difference right here. Because if you come over here to the list that we're using, this is the first entry and this is the last entry. So the list is actually being represented exactly like it is right here. So all we need to do is really, instead of using the index, we need to create kind of a reverse index. Let's call it that. And I mean, literally, let's call it that. I'm going to create an int, call it reverse index. And now comes the magic. What you do is you take the list length, and the list is literally this list right here. So essentially what you're saying is list.length, aka 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or whatever the number is once we add more to the list. Right now it's 5, and then you're saying -1 minus the index. And that's literally it. Now I come over here and I take the reverse index, and instead of using index over here, I just use reverse index. And if you have more variables where you're using the index, you obviously also have to replace it, depending on your case. But I'm sure you figured out what I'm doing by now. So now that this is done, if I just save the project, you will see that it already takes into effect. The order has officially been changed, and if I just do, let's say the 19th, let's just say I went there again, and I just add to the list, there it is, it's added to the top of the list. So if you've ever wanted to know how to reverse a ListView.builder, this is how. And if you do the math, you will see that this makes a lot of sense. I hope this was able to help you. If it did, you already know, hit that like button. And if you don't already subscribe, then what are you waiting for? Hit that subscribe button and keep learning more and more about Flutter. Thank you so much for watching. This is Flutter Mentor, and out.